little bit of very interesting thing I am going to do. You see a homeopathy bottle.
Yes.
See? And what I am going to do, I am putting some water here inside this, and there is a mark also. I am putting this water.
The mark.
No, more than the mark. I put it inside water and see what happens. What is the condition like this?
It's
where the buoyant force is?
Equal.
The weight and buoyant force are equal. Now this bottle I take it, and then I very carefully take it out and place it in the. So it is coming up?
Yes.
Same condition, I reduce little bit. It is completely immersed in water. Now, can you see the water level inside the bottle? Is it just above the red line? The water level inside the small bottle, is it just above it?
Yes.
See?
Yes.
Carefully see.
Yes.
Now, press it. Press it. Ready?
It came.
What happened? What is the condition? The condition is?
The condition is
weight is more. See, it is now not going up, going very slowly, very slowly, because it is almost equal. And when you press, slowly press it. Press it. See, the water level, has it gone up inside the bottle?
Yes.
It has gone up. So, as the more water has gone up, the weight becomes less. So, the weight, as it compresses the air, that air compressed, it pushes the water down. So, it becomes light. When you press, it goes down. When you release it, it goes up. This is actually a law which is called Pascal's law. Pascal's law. Pascal said that in a confined mass of fluid, if a pressure is applied, that pressure is transmitted everywhere uniformly. It uniformly spreaded all over the liquid inside, liquid or fluid. And what happened when I press it, because of this extra force, it goes inside the bottle. So, the bottle sinks. And when I release it,
it again comes up.
This is the principle of a submarine. And in your book, it says Cartesian driver. In a submarine also, there are tanks where people used to pump in water so that it becomes heavy and it go inside
water.
And when pumped it out, it goes up. So, this is a toy submarine. By this, what we have covered today, that in this lecture, what is water pressure, how the water pressure changes with depth, and at the same level pressure remain constant, and because of this then we come to the buoyant force. That means any object is when dipped inside a liquid, the liquid exerts a upward force. Even it is fluid, actually correctly to be said it is the fluid, it exerts a upward force, and that upward force is called buoyancy. And we have measured how much is the buoyancy. When a body is immersed in a liquid, the amount of liquid it displaces, that weight is equal to the buoyant force, and that is really Archimedes' principle. Then with the help of this small three things we have established, then when the weight is more than the buoyant force, a body sinks. When the weight is exactly equal, it floats like this. It floats completely immersed within the liquid, and when it is buoyant force is more than the weight, then the body rises to the surface. This should be the statement. Whatever is written in the book is wrong. You have to say that when the buoyant force is more, it rises to the surface, and part of it is when it is out, then the buoyant force is equal to the weight. And lastly, with the help of this bottle and a small homeopathy bottle, we have proved how Pascal's law acts. So, it is the whole chapter normally taught in a class by the teachers in 4 or 5 classes. But if we apply this method with the YouTube and etcetera, then you can finish it one day. So, when teacher says that doing experiment actually we lose much of time, we cannot finish our syllabus, that is wrong. If you do the experiment, then student will understand themselves, because in this session I have never said a word for teaching. Whatever they said is from the experience. They said what is happening and they learned it, and so it is, I think it is very helpful for them, and teachers should adopt this. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.